Hey guys, and welcome back to Let's Play Kingsfield 2. So, if you looked at the comments at all, I've been chatting with Mr. Master Devil, and he pointed out to me that I completely forgot about this Silveira's Key shortcut earlier on in the game because I'm a moron. And that's something I actually remember noticing now that I think about it. So I'm going to take out this Silveira's Key. We'll get some back, so don't worry about it. We'll get some back. But anyways, I just completely blanked out because I've been making these less plays and haven't been exploring as much. So yeah, there was a Silveira's Key I noted at the beginning, and I forgot to put a Silveira's Key in it to actually go through. And I was talking about the shortcut to the beginning of Silveira's Wall, David Silveira's Wall, and I think that this is actually where it is. So let's go ahead and do that. So I believe it was this way. And something I totally didn't notice before. The beautiful blood red sky of the land of Verdites. It's gorgeous. Imagine waking up to that every day. All right, so this was the one I forgot about. So let's go ahead and drop a Silveira's Key here. Now if I'm correct, and this is the entrance, or the one that we missed at the beginning. Yeah, okay, so this is that door at the beginning. So now we can easily get back to the beginning town. Go talk to Ed Edmondson again. And go talk to the lady who lost her son. Oh, no, this is just the save point. I was going to say, I think the lady who lost her son was this way, but I guess it's just going forward further. The other thing we're going to have to do is grab all of our Silveira keys and head back to that entrance. So we'll have a couple extra Silveira keys. I think maybe one extra in total, but maybe two. Regardless, more Silveira keys. That means I can get further in that area where I got the rapier, so I'm excited about that. Hey, lady, guess what? I found your son! He was dead.
Thanks to you, my son has finally been set free. Here, take this map. I don't need it anymore now that he's safe. I'll pray for your safety, Lyle, and your victory, too.
Aw, you're so much sweeter than the people of Raluga who suck. The map has nothing on it. It is a blank map.
I have a friend named James Seward McCain Thought the Fifth, who is waiting for Commander Silveira to return. If you ever happen to see him, please tell him that my son has finished his task.
Alright, so I guess this is good. So we found out about James Seward McCain the Fifth, and now maybe this will open some dialogue option for us.
I'd like to return to my house. I had a beautiful view of the ocean from there. It was just magnificent.
Was the ocean also blood red, just like the sky? Because that would make sense if you think about why the ocean is blue and why the sky is blue. The ocean is blue because of the sky being blue. I think it's that way. I think that's the right way.
About the time that the king suddenly changed and the demons began to appear, my hometown was covered with a deep snow. The beach began to drop and shift, and an ugly cliff replaced our beautiful beach.
Crazy.
I was operating an inn at that time. Most people used to come to visit there. The scenery was gorgeous. We were also very proud of our beautiful country. On a clear day, you could see the island of Melanet.
Island of Melanet. Kingsfield 1 reference. That's where you are in the entirety of Kingsfield 1.
You couldn't describe the beauty with words. Since the day, the sky has been nothing but dark, gray, and gloomy.
And red.
I wish the beauty would return. I used to play on the beach as a child. I'd find things floating in the water from far off lands. It was like a dream. I'm sorry to bore you with an old woman's memories, but I feel like you're a part of my family. Please come again soon. Take care of yourself.
I wonder, because Lyle was young before things turned to shit in Verdite. I wonder how much of old Verdite he got to experience. And the skies were always blood red. But, wait. What? Ah? I missed that Earth Herb? Well, now it's even better I came back. So let's go talk to Ed. This is gonna suck a bit, this little bit of backtracking I'm doing, so I'm apologize. Whoa, Ed, what are you doing over here? Hello. Hello, Ed. Hello.
I hear you're planning to go to the castle.
In that case, I suggest you stop at your mother's tomb and pray for your soul's safe passage. Going to that castle is suicide.
Your mom is suicide. I won't die.
I've heard of your works in this miserable beast-infested kingdom, yeah. People like you come along occasionally, peddling hope for a better future. I hope you can bring peace to this place.
Doesn't sound certain. He sounds like he doesn't believe. He's like peddling around hope.
Maybe you can manage to stay alive long enough to do some good. That's been the problem with the others. They either disappear or die. Please be careful. Don't get yourself killed too.
I'm not David Silveira, don't worry. I'm Dave Klein.
I've dug hundreds of graves. I don't want to have to dig one for you. I hope I don't have to dig one for Commander Silveira either.
Wait. Silveira? I thought Silveira was dead. Is he gonna be a boss?
Here's some free advice from a guy who's been around. If you don't have one already, get a hold of the silver ring. There are many creatures here that carry poison, so if you want to stay alive, you'll wear a silver ring.
I bet he sells a silver ring. Oh, he doesn't. That'd be funny.
And guess where you can buy one? From me, Aaron Mixon. I sell many silver rings as I've had the silver ring emporium.
Either that or get used to carrying tons of the antidote for that with you.
Yeah, that's what I did. That's what I did.
For example, I have a staff called the Flame Rod. Very rare and powerful. There's also a twin staff called the Silence Rod. Together, the two staffs make up an even more powerful pair.
I wonder if Silence Rod just makes it so they can't use magic? Because that's usually what silence means in games.
I'm still looking for the Silence Rod, so if you ever find it, bring it here and I'll pay you handsomely for it. My collection is the only pleasure I have in this miserable life.
Your collection stolen from dead corpses! So that's all he's got to say. He still hasn't opened the secret passage for us. Although maybe there's a secret at my mother's tomb that he was blocking before. A moonstone. At a tombstone. Maybe this is my mom's? Tombstone. What? The what? Vice Commander Kane, forever we shall lift up your flame. So I don't see my mom's tomb anywhere. Let's see if there's a secret passage in the back here. Anything outside of a moonstone? No. No, there isn't. What the hell, Ed Edmondson? I thought you had more to do. We shall come back for you. We shall come back after I get all my Silveira keys. And we have to run and grab now. Run and grab the Silveira keys. Status update for you guys on the Kingsfield lore videos. Yes, I'm still working on them. Don't worry. Or video. We'll see. I don't know if I'm going to do more than one. I mean, I might do one per game. I'm probably going to do one about the... So, okay, I will grab the Silveira key after I get the other Silveira keys. And then backtrack it. This is just so I can get more Silveira keys. Anyways, update. Yeah. So, I will probably be doing a general Kingsfield 1 story video as a lore video, just kind of explaining the story of it. And I kind of gathering all that. The instruction manual has a lot to say. It's like 4 pages of story in the instruction manual. But I'm going to try and make it a little more interesting and then have examples from the game like I typically have in my Dark Souls lore videos in different references and citations and stuff like that and quotes. I think this brings us back to, yeah, so this, if we go down here, this is the barracks. So from doing this, basically we get one extra Silveira key and a quicker way back to Kist, the beginning part of the game. So because this will be one Silveira key and then we'll get that other, which will give us two. Which before, but since we have one before negative one, that equals one. Anyways, that's what I'm thinking about doing for the Kingsfield lore video. I might do some on the various characters, but to me they're not as intense and interesting as like the Dark Souls characters because they all have such extensive stories. I mean, Alfred and his sister, the main bad guy from Kingsfield 1, whose name I'm currently blanking on, I'm trying to remember his name. Anyways, I find his interesting, but since he's a main plot point, and so is his sister, and their friend who they go with, Fi, who's their friend,
I'll probably be talking about them a bunch. And just in general, like, all the crystal miners don't have extensive backstories. So they're kind of just guys who probably came to the island for the sake of gaining wealth and money and crystals. The island of Melanet. For those of you guys only watching Kingsfield 2 videos. But, and then once I finish Kingsfield 2, I'll probably do a Kingsfield 2 lore video as well. But yes, I am working on it. Let's see if Ed Edmixon has anything else to say. Hello, Ed. You're still looking for the Silence Rod. You have given us no details at all. Thank you for nothing. For nothing! But we still got 2 Sylveira keys. So now I can go up a little bit further into that area I was in Sylveira's barracks. So, hey, better than nothing. And eventually we'll go back to the beginning of the game too, back to Kist. I'm kind of holding off mainly... Oh, I don't need to go. That's not the right way. I'm mainly holding off. Ooh, you know what I just realized? I should go get some blue potion right now and heal myself up fully without wasting anything. Yeah, just like that. Yeah, so anyways, I don't need to save. That's okay. I think. No, let's save. I'm like, I don't know what's beyond the area I'm about to go to, and it could be unsafe, so let's save it. Anyways, I will be going back to Kist, which was the very beginning of the game. Eventually, I want to be able to open up the Pharaoh's Tomb before I go. I'm just calling it a Pharaoh's Tomb because it reminds me of the Egyptian Pharaoh aesthetic. Actually, is it? No, that's like a royal grave. Which I guess would be, my mom is a royal. Anyways, I will go back there. But I don't think I can open it yet. If I'm wrong, you can go ahead and chime in on the comments and tell me I'm being a stupid idiot. And I'm totally wrong and I should go back to the beginning of the game. But I don't think I can. There's also a chest I couldn't open before that maybe the copper key would open. But I'm not sure. I'm not sure if it would. But I will go back to Kist. Don't worry. It will happen. Now I'm kind of curious. I'm like, what if? Because there are 2 skeletons guarding that Pharaoh's treasure chest. So I kind of do wonder if it just opens. Oh well. Anyways, here we are at the Sylveira's Key area again! Again! I was really just planning on jumping back into the Maze of Varde and heading into Reluga. Which apparently, according to Mr. Master Devil, there are a couple things I missed in Reluga. And not Reluga. In the Maze of Varde. I actually went ahead and just kind of checked for where they were ahead of time because I didn't want you guys to have to watch me exploring. I thought that'd be boring. So, alright. One more Sylveira's Key. Will there be more? I don't know. This has been a chain of a zillion Sylveira keys. You know, if it's a dead end, we can actually start taking out Sylveira keys as well. Just want to point that out. What's up, buddy? Oh, that didn't do anything. Ha! Okay, I still hit you. I'm not doing well, but I got a strength up. And I will send a fireball into your face. I do like how quick this is. That's nice. And it's very much in the center of the frame that I hit. Oh, man. I'm doing terrible against these guys. Wow, I don't even know why I chose to attack with my rapier then. I knew I was going to miss. These guys have very loose bones that I just swing and shoot my rapier right through them. Okay. Will there be a trap door? Because it looks like one up there. I guess not. Ha! It opened! Ha! And I got a fire crystal! Ha ha ha! Which I shall use. I wonder if that gives you more fire crystal magic. A new spell. Or maybe it just ups your fire magic, how good your fire magic is. That is locked. God, what about you? You are locked as well. Hopefully the copper keys will take care of both of these. And we can start collecting back up our Sylveira keys. Alright. Let's see. My fire magic is at 26. So I use a fire crystal. It is now at 29. And I do not have any more fire spells. So I guess it just literally raises up how powerful you are. And that would be it. Alright, copper key worked on that one. And copper key worked on that one. Perfect. Perfect. I'm still afraid of skeletons popping out. And we get some blood rubies. So, Alright, nothing too interesting in here, honestly. Unless there's a secret passage. Aha! I was like, come on, there has to be. This is the final area. Whoa! Okay. Whole new passageway. That will say, hey, you need a Silviera key. Go further through the secret passage. I bet this is gonna want a Silviera key. What do you hold? What do you- Ah! Damn you! Oh well, at least I found this and explored enough to know that I'm going to need it. We will never be done with this barracks. We will be coming back forever. Maybe if I come back again, I'll also go back to Kist. And these skeletons are back too. They want to have some more fun. I didn't kill them enough times. One time was not enough times. Alright, at least I hit him with that. I'm running low on magic, so good thing we're heading to Beluga right about now. So I can get... not waste any precious moonstones, even though I have a ton of them. I can get that gold potion, go kill blood red things. It'll be great. It'll be fantastic. Did I check for the secret walls here? Probably, but I'm gonna do it again. Okay, so nothing interesting there yet. Until we get the next Silviera key. Ugh. Alright, we will be back. Again. Yet again. With another Silviera key. Let's go ahead and use the blue potion, because we're going to be heading to Reluga. And we're not going to need the blue potion anymore, because we're going to be finding a gold potion. Yeah! Hopefully I don't need to use these Silviera keys to find the Silviera key to move forward in the Silviera key area of Silviera keys. Because that's like four right now that are placed. So we shall see where it leads to. But another Silviera key placed in the chain of Silviera keys. So at least I guess they're all in one place and we know where they all are. Alright. Heading back to the Maze of Arde where I missed one really important thing and one useful thing according to Mr. Master Demon. I think Demon, right? Yeah, say that. And then after that, we shall head into Reluga. You know, this maze area is of binary is almost nicer than outside, because at least the sky isn't blood red in here. There just is no sky. I guess it's charming. I live in the charming city of Verdite, the charming town and land. Our skies are blood crimson red. It is just beyond charming. Okay, so first thing I missed was along the riverside, along the river bend, so we shall go there. And actually, I think there are two things I missed, but one I cannot get yet. Do you say anything new? Varde, I want new info.
Deep in the woods, you will find the Palace of Wind, which was built by King Harbine. 7 or 8 years ago, Kalmathar, the Archmage of Wind, headed toward there. I'm sure she must still be there.
So I guess Kalmathar is who I was talking to, huh?
One thing you should know, though, is that you cannot enter the Wind Palace unless you possess the power of Wind. And even then, you will find the palace full of evil spirits led by Harbine. People seldom return from there.
Harbine died, by the way, on the Isle of Melanith. He has a castle in Melanith as well.
King Harbine left his guard, John Creel, to guard the entrance. John has been faithful to his task now for over 300 years!
Wow, John Creel is old, and I guess John Creel, that's who we were talking to at the beginning.
When Harbine died, I hear that the palace was covered with a thick, mystical darkness. It's been that way ever since.
So I guess when he died in the Isle of Melanith.
Time is short. Even as we speak, the seal of the castle is weakening. You must hurry to discover the remaining seals of Icarus. Make haste! Time is short!
I had a feeling that was the last line. Alright, when you see it, usually when they have two letters, like two sentences that are that short, it's their last line. That... Where is that tree thing at? Did I find that? What? I don't remember ever seeing that. I guess it's like one of those torches, but still. Wait a second. Wait. Where's my... I'm probably gonna get shot from behind, aren't I? I am not at all going towards the river bend. I went through this totally wrong way. I wanted to go to the river bend. Whoops. Alright, well, my mistake. We shall head back to the beginning area so we can head to the river bend. Oh, well, he has some interesting stuff to say. Right, so it was all good. I think this is the way to the river bend. Yes. This is the way to the river bend. My mistake. Whoops. Alright, so... Yeah, I'm not... That drop does not look safe to me. That's okay. We don't need two antidotes. I'll live without them. I guess. I'll live without the two antidotes. Because honestly, I don't think I would survive that right there. However, we shall head towards the other river bend, area. And past John Creel's cave, where he's hidden out. That's okay. I don't need to kill you right now, true dude. I'm on a mission for items I missed. Okay, here we go. So here's the river bend. And before I popped over to the left, if you guys remember, and this is where I found the armor. So I realized that I actually missed this over here. However, I believe it's locked. Yeah. Let's see if the copper key works. The copper key does not work. Jail key does not work. Okay. I swear I will remember that. I will remember about that one, because apparently I've been forgetting about things. Okay, so here's the other side. And there's a chest over there. And that looks like it's it. So, this chest is not locked. And this sweet shield is inside. What does this shield do? I don't know what it does. But it looks better than the iron shield, so I'm going to equip it. I could be wrong. Actually, I could check the stats, and that way I'll know. So this has, actually, yeah, it has Earth Magic Defense, which is not surprising. 51, 49, 46. So, its Slash and Blow Defense is slightly not as good, but its Stab Defense is better. Plus, it has that Earth Magic Defense, so I'm going to go ahead and keep it equipped. But it's interesting, it's actually not totally better than the Iron Shield, per se. Now, if it has any special status effects that it does to help you out, that I do not know. It might, but I just don't know. Because I can't read it! I'm illiterate now. I need to become more wise. I need more wisdom. So I can read these things. I just want to be smart. I'm nobly born. I should be able to read. I'm supposed to be very smart with my noble birth. Even though... Well, I guess you did grow up for a while before Alfred grew evil, because we met that girl who was friends with us before things went to shit. Oh, wait. I have 4 MP now. So... I think actually Mr. Master Demon said this, but yeah, so it looks like it gives you MP recovery, although very slow MP recovery nonetheless. So that's pretty awesome. Actually, that's actually really, really good and really useful. So I'm cool with that, and I will take the slightly dropped defense and slightly raised defense in some instances. In favor of that. Alright. the map of Verdite. Oh wow, this is actually a pretty cool map. So, the Pixie map is going to be the useful map, but this one's kind of cool just for the sake of seeing what everything actually looks like. So you see Kiss down at the bottom, and then we had to go through the barracks to the left over there, or the wall, to get into the Mesa Verde, which is where I'm at now. And then we're going to be heading down to Relugo. And Relugo will lead us down into that watery-looking area that might be lava at this point in time. Or maybe it's water, so I guess we'll find out. But I just saw a lot of water before. Anyways, Pixie's map. This looks like the way I want to go. So, we shall go this way. So, Relugo is over to the right there, but I think. Right? Oh, no, Relugo is this way, I guess. Oh yeah, so Relugo is over through there, right in that area. However, before we go in there, there is the one thing I missed. The other thing, which is a wise fruit. And I think it's over this, oh no. This way is a dead end, so it's not over that way. It would be over this way. And yep, so I always check every barrel. I forgot to check this barrel. So that is wise fruit, and if we look at it, what it does. This fruit was said to have been planted by Valid. Eating this fruit will cause intelligence to increase. Now let's look at some of these items. We can't read any of them. And our, right now, if you look at our wisdom stat on the right there, it's at 1, right next to power. So, if we use this wise fruit, my intelligence will go up. And you see my intelligence, my wisdom's now at 2. And if we look at some of these items that we couldn't look at before, like, but look what we knew. The Dragon Crystal. This crystal gives total recovery to the injured body and mind, meaning intelligence and HP, HP and MP. This fruit of the dragon tree is useful for sudden damaging body changes. So it's not really straight up telling you still that if you die, you will use one and come back to life. But at least it tells you now it's a full recovery item, I suppose. So now we get the Bloodstone. The red gem contains magical power and will cure conditions inflicted by magical attacks as well as instantly cure paralysis. The Moonstone. This is the stone which contains the moon's magical power. It is effective for regaining magic points. So there we go. This is actually telling us what some of this stuff does now. Jail key is still the key to the door. So I guess we're not totally able to read everything yet. My earth shield is nothing. Okay. My high metal armor. This is made of special alloy and is extremely lightweight. It is worn by officers of the Verdite Army. Whereas the iron plate was armored infantry. So we have gotten the officer's gear now, which is always going to be a little bit better. Alright, so green bracelet. We still don't know what it does, so I will keep it equipped. Now, I believe that is all the items I missed here in the Maze of Arde. So, with that done, and all these things I missed wrapped up in 30 minutes of this playthrough, that took a little too long. I'm sorry about that. Let us head into Relugo, and we shall save a sickly child. Because he is sick, and I feel bad about that. Sickly child, we are coming. We are coming. That sounds really bad. Forward, deeper into the red skies of the beautiful town of Relugo. We shall make a postcard out of it and send it to our family members. We'll send a postcard to Lyle's father. I'm sure he would appreciate it. King Alfred. I don't know why I decided to instantly go to the back of the sign and try to read the back. So Relugo, birthplace of King Alfred the First. I'm just seeing if this guy has anything new to say. We probably have to go cure the kid for a lot of new info.
The South River used to be beautiful with clear water, but now the demons have turned it into a churning bed of glowing lava. The cave beyond that was dug by the Archmage Shaddam. They changed the spelling of his name. Strange place that must be. It used to be Shaddam, S-H-A-A-D-A-M, or S-H-A-D-D-A-M, in Kingsfield 1.
I guess they changed the spelling because they think this would more accurately be how you'd spell his name. Shudom would be how you pronounce that in Japanese. I'm gonna keep calling him Shaddam, though, because that's what he was in Kingsfield 1.
Shaddam was called the Dark Lord of the Earth Spirits. He created beings out of the very Earth. It's been quite a while since his departure, but you can still hear the howling of his dark spirits from within that cave.
So Shaddam also went to Melanit, FYI. And yeah, he was the Earth guy. And that was how we got the Spider Sword. That's the super secret sword in Kingsfield 1, is associated with Shaddam and Earth magic. And the Earth Elementals were also Shaddam's beings, and those guys were the dinosaurs in Kingsfield 1. It's at the bottom of the Big Mine, which is a big event in Kingsfield 1. The dark spirits from within the cave. Shaddam was called the Dark Lord of the Earth Spirits. Why was he called the Dark Lord?
No one was ever gone to the cave of Shaddam and returned, and no one in his right mind would ever go near it now.
You scare me. I'm very sorry, but I'm afraid I can't let you stay in the inn. Oh, so it's his inn. Why do I scare him? I'm just chilling and talking to him.
Your father is responsible for the kingdom's undoing. Unless you can do something to save it, you are no better than the king himself.
Oh, seriously? Well, then you're no better than the king himself either if you can't save it. So why don't you go save the kingdom, asshole?
Yeah, I'm no better than the king himself for nothing, something I had nothing to do with. And because I can't, magically cure the land, it's what I'm trying to do.
God, what an asshole. I don't like him at all. I will never like him, ever.
Jane Cowley, also a bag of D.
What's up, Jane?
Ha. Okay. Relugo, town of D-bags.
Whatever.
Whatever.
I'm so angry I'm gonna take it out on this Bellsprout.
But it's just a Pokemon, Dave. He's just trying to live. He's just trying to live and be caught by a Pokeball and live forever in a Pokeball.
So this doesn't seem to be doing... The Rakier does not seem to be doing as much damage as the Broadsword. Which we pretty much determined. I mean, just depending on who we were fighting or talking to.
Anyway, I'm very busy.
Okay, that's what he said last time. Yeah, so for the most part, everyone's saying the same stuff, so... let's just go ahead and take care of some business. Let's take care of some business, and then we'll get back to these guys. Now I'm gonna switch back to my broadsword, because it seems to be a little bit better. Even if it is slow. It does look cooler to me. Honestly, I just don't like how slow it is. It's really the recovery speed, the slowness of that, that's kind of annoying me. But only two hits for a double-headed Bellsprout. I mean, that's pretty rockin'. That is pretty rockin'. So we need to go back to the lava area and run along the side, I believe. That would be my belief for where we need to go. And check it. Yeah, now we're at 8 for our MP, so that has been slowly recovering. We're at 3. Before I picked up that, before I equipped the Earth Shield. Okay, so this would be the this is not the correct way to go. But, wait. How do I get that treasure chest anyways? Oh, I guess I have to run around the other side of this. Yeah. Gold potion. The best potion. Yes. Yes! Let's get more gold potion. We shall fill up our one single crystal flask. For more gold potion. Ah, the beautiful flowing rivers of lava. That's what I think of Relugo as. That's why they're so butthurt and angry. Danger! Because they've been drinking lava. Let's go into the dangerous area. For it is our destiny. Oh, God. Not more Daddy Longlegs. Hello, Daddy Longleg. Hello. Okay. Yeah, the mushrooms are... Whoa! Holy crap. Is that... Are you what shot that poison mist at me? Daddy Longleg? Whoa, these take more than two hits from my broadsword. Jeez, these mushrooms are intense. This Daddy Longleg is about to be intense because he shoots poison mist at me. Okay, wrapping around Daddy Longleg. Even though there's another one coming from me. Oh, wow. Okay, Daddy Longleg's not too bad. Only take two hits. So, actually, they're surprisingly not bad at all. Whew, that was close. He almost hit me. I know the Daddy Long Legs at the beginning really hurts you at the beginning of the game. And again, that's before you have any armor whatsoever. And that's why I'm so nervous about these blood red ones, even though two hits, really not bad at all. Ooh. Oh. Another broken knight sword. Don't like this area. You know why. I don't even need to say why. Alright, let's see if that fireball does anything. It does. So it only takes two hits instead of three. I'm all for that. Oh crap, I'm facing the same direction as this guy. Not all for that at all. Level up! Okay, so before I was talking about the level ups, not doing anything for your strength and or attack power. If you look at your strength, I don't think it is affecting it. I don't think it's like getting a strength up, but according to Mr. Master, you do get more attack power for leveling up. But maybe it's just very minimal, because I haven't found it yet at all noticeable. Oh, here we go. We found it. We found the herb that they needed. That, I didn't have to kill. I thought I was going to drop out of a monster the way they described it. So there's the blood herb. This is the special herb which is effective for sudden illness at the passage of poison. It will purify infected blood. We did it! We have saved the small child that I swore to save. Come time. But hey, we did it. So that's pretty sweet. Alright, I want to see what's further here before I go finish saving him. Because I don't know. I mean, it might not be a dead end. Maybe this is like further on, but it might be a dead end. So once I save them, I bet they're going to open up the inn for me, and they're going to throw a sweet party. Everyone's going to love me all of a sudden. It'll be pretty sweet. I just want them to throw me a party, but preferably a surprise party. I don't want to know what's coming, because then I'll feel more special about myself, because I'll be like, oh, you guys, you really do care. I thought you didn't. And then everyone will dance. It'll be plenty of fun. Yeah. Surprise party in my name. That's all I ask for, but I'm not asking for it. I don't know. I'm just asking one of my friends. I'm only telling one of them I want a surprise party. I'm hoping the info will get out and it'll happen, but everyone will think that they're just throwing me a surprise and it's not something that I would ever ask for. So we can't go into this inn because that douche won't let us. Total bag of dicks. That guy. Alright, is this where the kid is? No, it's not. See, I'm just doing this out of my own good heart, trying to save this kid. Like, it's not even because the people hate me. I'm just trying to be a nice guy. Yet, they're like, oh, screw you, I want to let you stay at my inn. Oh, which apparently you get dreams from staying at inns. Forgot about that. Thank you, Mr. Master. Thank you. Okay, I'm back, and I got the blood herb for you. Do I have to use it? He lost consciousness. Just please help him. Okay. Okay. Calm down. Calm down. Alright. Check this. I'm going to use this blood herb on myself. How sad would that be if you used it and you just used it on yourself by accident? Nothing. Wait. Did. Seriously? Maybe if I give it to the mother? I was really nervous that it said nothing happens, like, I used it on myself and nothing happened. With this medicine, my son will certainly recover. I can see that I was wrong to listen to others about you. Thank you. Thank you very much. You're welcome. All in a day's work of being the son of the king. Alright. Let's see if anyone else has anything new to say now that we did it. Let's see if we can go into the inn, or if they're still being jerks. I don't think this is the inn, but Mark Johnson. Oh yeah, this is the elder who wouldn't tell us anything. He was like, you must study, and I have a book in front of me, but you must study.
I'm trying to find the meaning of the truth to make it a part of me. What do you call a cross between a banana and a gymnast? A banana split. Trivial matters in this kingdom don't interest me.
Wait. Is that joke really in this game? That's ridiculous. That... Wow. Okay. FromSoft. Trivial matters don't interest them, except for the different... What you call a cross between a banana and a gymnast. Alright. He likes punny type of jokes. That was very punny of you, sir. By the way, your house is being haunted by a giant hell sprout. Let me take care of that infestation for you. He's okay. He's an okay guy because he likes punny jokes. I guess I really don't need to be killing these guys. It's probably a waste of time. But they're in front of me and they need to die because they're in front of me. So, sorry about all the backtracking. I know there hasn't been anything new in this so far. Not much new yet in this Let's Play Kingsfield. There are just things I need to take care of. I need to take care of some business. But, you know, that wise fruit, definitely a good get. And, we'll see if, like, these... Oh, now I can go into the inn. There we go. And he transported to his inn.
There's a building near Ralugo that was erected by Harvine, the King of Wind. If you go there, God save your soul. You must be extremely careful. There are as many dangers there as around the Cape of Shaddam.
A building near Ralugo. Huh. Okay. Interesting. So, is he talking about that building at... I wonder if he's talking about the building like by the Maze of Mepharde.
You're looking for the four of Archmages, right? Leon said this would happen. I heard a while back that someone saw Ungrund, the Archmage of the Earth, near the Lava River.
Sweet, so I definitely want that, to go find Ungrund, Archmage of Earth. I guess he's the new Archmage since Shaddam is dead.
I've heard that the Archmages made an alliance in order to protect themselves from the evil creatures until the Chosen One's arrival. They went into hiding shortly after, and must have been waiting for you ever since.
So, if you knew all of this, why were you being such a jerk to me? I still don't like you.
I guess it's true. No one has seen the four Archmages together since, and it's been 10 years now.
It took you 10 years to figure that out? Until this very point? I don't like you. I will never like you. Ever. You are on my list of disliked people. I'm gonna steal your herbal liquid. Because I can use it since I'm off risking my life for blood poison, blood herbs. And so, okay, cool. So his house is in, has a save point in it. Which at this point is pretty useful. I feel like we did a lot. We made a lot of progress so far. Let's go ahead and stay at the inn and see if we have any dreams. As Mr. Master Devil told me there would be. So let's do this and check this out. I'm actually really curious about it. I don't really use my money anyway, so. Even though I'm full on everything. Whoa, I just like warp backwards. So far my, whoa. Okay. Eyeball statue with a sword. But what does it mean? It's probably part of the inside of the castle, I would assume. Okay, so the inn has been open to me. So, let's go ahead and talk to this sign. That is a road sign. Thank you for your help, road sign. Let's go talk to this lady. Our lady, and see what she has to say. Watermelon heads should be easy now, too. Should be, yeah. Now we can actually stun them. I'm so glad you guys are back. I missed you. Oh, man. Still 3 hits? Wow. Okay. So, easier, but... They are much more powerful than the Kingsfield 1. That just shows you how crazy Melanin is. If Watermelon Heads, the base creature of Kingsfield 1, is something Alexander was knocking out like nobody's business, then... Alexander must just be more powerful. That's all I can gather. Then Lyle. Alright. Let's go in this. I'll stop taking care of these monsters. And talk to our beautiful Lynn Reinhardt. See if she has anything new to say. See if she'll move so I can open up that treasure chest.
If only Father were back. I think he might be able to help. I think he used to have one of the pieces to the key that belonged to Icarus himself. But Father went to Garan in search of Prometheus. He just never came back.
Okay, so eventually we're going to go to Garan to find her father, Mr. Reinhardt, and be like, hey, I used to play with your daughter when I was little. You remember me? We used to have play dates.
Prometheus is the special medal which was handed down by the dwarfs. I know it's precious, but I don't think it's worth risking our lives for. Of course, Father had a very different view.
Maybe he thought, you know, that metal would help us get better weapons so he could kill the monsters.
Anything for a buck, especially for a fortune. I hear Garan is a very dangerous place. I can't help worrying about my father's safety. He's not as young as he used to be.
Don't worry, baby. With giant, giant ears, I will save your father, if he's not already dead.
My father was very close to the king in my childhood. That's why we used to go to the castle so often. My father would chat with the king about traveling and such. He used to be such a nice man.
Yeah, I still hate this voice I gave her, but I gave her this voice last time, so I'm continuing it.
While my father was chatting with the king, I used to take walks with Alexander in the courtyard. The flowers would be blooming. It was always so beautiful. That is actually where Alexander introduced me to you.
Why would Alexander introduce me to her as opposed to my father introducing me to her?
Ah, those were the good old days. Walks, laughter, games with the prince. You were my best friend back then, you know. With all the traveling, I didn't have any friends.
So, okay, cool. You're still my friend. You'll always be my friend, Lynn. Especially if you move and give me whatever is in the treasure chest behind you. Then you'll be my BFF. You'll be my best friend forever. I'm just saying, if you do that for me. Whoa, I missed this chest last time. Or did I and not miss it and just forget? No, I think I missed it. Oh wait, no, I didn't have the copper key last time I came, did I? Did I? I don't think I did. So, well, now we know what's inside. A blood ruby in case one of these guys poisons us, because they don't do anything else, they just poison you. Alright, so back at the grave, past the beginning person's house, and wait a second. No, wait. That's right, this is where that one guy is who's digging. Maybe he's moved at this point, and maybe that's where I'm supposed to go. Let's see if he moves. Are you somewhere new? You are not. Do you still think you're me? Probably. Okay, he clearly is still going insane. Listen. I know you've been drinking a little bit too much herbal liquid. I get it, but you need to lay off the herbal liquid just a little bit. It's messing with your mind, Brova. Alright, so let's see if he's magically in his house, even like right now. He just magically transports back and forth. No, alright, he's left his house. Let's steal his book that he was reading. I'm sure you can't. I'm sure there's nothing, but let's try anyways. Give me your book, you jerk. I'll never forgive you. Oh, the guy was working on the graves. Maybe he'll finally like me now. Now that I saved the kid. Do you like me?
Thank you for helping Iron. I'm sorry for my harsh words before. I had no intention of helping anyone in the royal family after what the king has done to us, but I'll make an exception for you now. How can I be of service? I've been carving tombstones here for the brave souls whose lives have been claimed by the minions of evil. I don't know how much longer I'll have to do this, but it's the least I can do for those brave men. Poor souls. I wonder when the end will come. Well, the end comes when you die.
Yep. That would be when the end comes. I can bring that to you for being mean and rude to me earlier, but I'll forgive you because you're not as douchey as the other dude who I do not like at all, forever.
I'm amazed you actually found the blood-sucking plant. Not all royal family members are bad after all. I don't know if you've been there or not, but the Palace of Wind lies to the north. The palace is magnificent and befitting of the king who ruled the three kingdoms long ago.
So that is where we shall be heading. Or we shall try and find Shaddam. We shall see. We shall see, and we shall find out. I didn't miss anything over here. There's just that inn. I do not believe so. So I'm gonna head to the northwest, west. Mainly west.
We shall head west.
What is it? I wonder what if the kids healed up. That'd be cool. Are you cured yet? Aha! He is! I want your toy dagger to poison you.
Thanks, mister. For a while, I was scared I was gonna die. Here, take this. I found it on one of my treasure hunts. It's my best treasure, but I want you to have it. Go on, take it.
You found a wind crystal?
Whoa! You like my dagger? I give this to you, but I can't. My daddy made it before he went away, and I'm never gonna let it go. Where are you going? Are you gonna to take care of those bad monsters before you go? If I were a little bigger, I'd show them a thing or two. If I find anything else, I'll make sure to show it to you. You're pretty cool. Thanks, kid. Thanks, kid. What about the mom? Aw, she's able to relax and sip on some tea. But she won't talk to me now. I just saved your kid. Why won't you talk to me? I guess she's busy sipping on tea. Oh, there we go.
I would like to express my deepest gratitude. As you can see, Iron is completely recovered. Please drop in and see us if you're ever in the neighborhood. Take care of yourself. Someday I just know you'll be able to give the hope back to your people that your father took away.
I hope so. I hope so, lady. So, I just want to double check and make sure, but I'm pretty positive that was a wind crystal that we got. Where is it? This is the magic stone containing wind magic. The magical power of wind will increase if you use this stone. We have no wind magic yet, so I'm going to hold on to it. Oh, my fire magic's not 30, not 3. It did not just drop insanely low. Alright, here we go. Now we're heading north into a save point. Alright, well, I think this will wrap up today's Kingsfield. Let's play Kingsfield 2. Sorry for a lot of backtracking in this episode. But next time, we've got all new ventures in front of us, unless I decide to backtrack back to Kist, which I'm not planning on doing yet. But anyways, next time, we will have plenty of new stuff to do. So again, sorry for the backtracking. I will see you guys next time. Peace.